Hello, Books for Kids fans. We're here to read How the Grinch Stole Christmas. Are you ready? If you watched the movie like a few minutes ago, then you'll already know what's gonna happen. How the Grinch Stole Christmas by Dr. Seuss. How the Grinch Stole Christmas by Theodore Seuss Geisel. That's Dr. Seuss's real name. Whoa, wait. You mean Dr. Seuss lied to us this whole time? Yeah. Oh. I wonder why. Whoa, Mr. Dinosaur, you're much calmer today. This is the first time I say something you don't like and you don't get irritated. Yeah, I did some meditation. Oh yeah, and I just wanted to tell you, I somehow removed the curse from the old lady who swallowed a cake. She made the curse for the video to get thinner and thinner until it got crushed. But I removed the curse somehow. Okay, every Jew down in Whoville liked Christmas a lot, but the Grinch, who lived just north of Whoville, did not. The Grinch hated Christmas, the whole Christmas season. Now please don't ask why. No one quite knows the reason. It could be his head wasn't screwed on just right. It could be perhaps that his sheets were too tight. But I think the most likely reason of all may have been that his heart was two sizes too small. But whatever the reason, his heart or his shoes, he stood there on Christmas Eve, hating the hills, staring down from his cave with a sour grinchy frown at the warm lighted windows below in their town. For he knew every Who down in Whoville beneath was busy now, hanging a mistletoe wreath. And were hanging their stockings, he snarled with a sneer. Tomorrow's Christmas, it's practically here. Vinny growled with his Grinch fingers nervously drumming. I must find some way to stop Christmas from coming. For tomorrow, he knew. Mary, Mary, all the Hill girls and boys would wake up bright and early. They'd rush for their toys, and then, noise. That's one thing he hated. But noise. Oh no, the Christmas tree is in the way. It's kind of hard for me to turn the page. Oh great, we're stuck on this page. Can only go back. But not forth. Oh man, how are we gonna read this book? I'd have to destroy the Christmas tree. Sorry, Hills. Oh no, we have a big table. It's gonna be hard for me to turn the page again. Then the Hills, young and old, would sit down to a feast. And they feast, and they feast, and they feast, 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 feast. They would feast on Hill pudding and rare Hill roast beast, which is something the Grinch couldn't stand in the least. And then they do something he liked least of all. Let me just skip a little bit until when he meets little Cindy Lou Who. Okay, so then he slide down the chimney or whatever, right. Tight pitch, but if Santa could do it, and so could the Grinch, then He got stuck only once for a moment or two. And let me just skip to when he meets little Sandy Lou Who. Yeah, I'll just skip. Then he stuffed all of the good food up a chimney with glee. And now, grinned the Grinch, I will stuff up the tree. And he and the Grinch grabbed the tree and he started to shove when he heard a small sound like the coo of a dove. He turned around fast and he saw a small hill, little Cindy Lou Who. It was not more than two. The Grinch had been caught by this tiny little daughter who got out of her bed for a cup of cold water. She stared at the Grinch and said, "Santa Claus, why are you taking our Christmas tree?" "Why?" Now let's skip to the part where he turns good. Boo hoo. "That's a noise," grinned the Grinch, "but I simply must hear." So he paused, and the Grinch put his hand to his ear, and he did hear a sound rising from the snore, was rising. The Grinch did hear a sound rising out of the snow. It started in low, and it started to grow. But the sound wasn't sad. Why? It sounded merry. It couldn't be so, but it was merry. Very! He stared down at Whoville. The Grinch popped his eyes, and he shook. What he saw was a shocking surprise. Oh, look, his hat is falling off. Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, was singing without any presents at all. He hadn't stopped Christmas from coming. It came, somehow or another. It came just the same. And the Grinch, with his Grinch feet ice cold in the snow, stood puzzling and puzzling. How could it be so? It came without ribbons. It came without tags. It came without packages, boxes, or bags. Then he puzzled 3 hours till his puzzler was sore. Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before. Maybe Christmas, he thought. Doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more. And what happened then? Well, in Whoville they say that the Grinch's small heart grew 3 sizes that day. And the minute his heart didn't feel quite so tight, he was with his load through a bright morning light. And he brought back the toys and the food for the feast. And he himself, the Grinch, carved the roast beast. So, how did you like this Books for Kids video? Grow your heart 3 sizes. This was pretty good. I know, Big Mickey. Thanks for joining us on this Books for Kids video. And by the way, if you saw the Grinch movie, you know an emotional attachment to little Cindy Lou Who and the Grinch. So I made this picture of Cindy Lou Who and the Grinch together. And when the sun was setting. And also, here are some shout outs. Here are the shout outs. There, shout outs. Bye.